There's nothing to get hung about. Strawberry feels forever. Always know sometime, think it's me. I know you know in a dream. It's getting hard to be someone, but it all works out. That is, I think I disagree. Let me take you down, 'cause I'm going to Strawberry Fields. Nothing is real. There's nothing to get hung about. Strawberry Fields forever. Strawberry Fields forever. Strawberry Fields forever.
Good, here's to you guys. We are live.
That's cool.
Cool. Are we live?
We're on. Are we live?
Hi.
Cool.
Out there in Cyberville.
Good to see Michael Lecompt. Michael Lecompt's here. Nice. This is great. This is fantastic. We've been trying to do this for a while.
I know.
You're too busy, man.
No. I'm glad I'm here.
You're too busy.
No, believe me, I like having off. I like staying around the house.
So you come on your night out to do this with around the table with us?
With some icons here. I told a lot of people about this, and they were like, really? I'm like, yeah, can you get me in? No. Absolutely not.
Yeah, it's funny. I got a lot of people that, friends that are followers of you, and I speak to them like all the time, and I'm like, I wish I could get you in. I can't get you in.
I'm here. I'm here. I'm glad to be here.
Well, we're glad to have you here.
I was here one time before with you.
Yeah, we did that like eight years ago.
And we did another gig on the street back
right
there.
Right there on 40th Street.
Yeah,
then we did the New York City gig.
Oh.
That one at 40th Street was, I was like there was a moment, it was started off tough, and then it was like we were dreaming. It was so good.
It was insane.
But the New York City gig was wacky.
Yeah.
That was great.
It was so wild, you stopped drinking after that for about 10 years.
Yeah, I stopped drinking after that, but I had a good time that night because I went to it. I'd say hello to Michelle out there if she's watching. Michelle. I mean.
Where's the sound? Everybody's asking where the sound is.
Yeah.
Where's the sound?
Can they hear us?
Oh, I'm afraid of that.
Oh, good. They didn't hear it.
Check.
Hey, you want to?
Audio. Where's the sound?
Where is it?
Okay.
Sorry about that. All right, let's start everything all over.
Okay, cool.
Good to have you here, Mike.
Nice to be here, you guys.
All right, Mike, man. Good to see you, man.
I'm excited. I was slept till 3 o'clock.
What time did you go to sleep?
6, maybe.
Like 6, yeah.
6. I get up doing a lot during the night, you know what I mean? Like all night, but it's just routine stuff. But I'm off tomorrow. I'm off Thursday. I'm playing Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, and... it's good. I like having off, like, you know, gives you time to do your mind and create some stuff, you know?
Yeah, that's cool.
So all we can do, right, is be creative at this point.
It's good. It's good. I was posting kind of a little bit bragging generally on Facebook that between all three of us, we're going to, you know, Anthony was going to join us, but unfortunately he can't make it, but between all three of us, we've done about 15,000 gigs. You doing probably 9 out of this.
Well, he's probably done, we've done 50,000 gigs, he's done 30,000 of them.
I was fortunate to do this kind of thing, but in these times we're living in, it's nothing to take away from the frontliners, because give all the credit to them, nurses, doctors, everybody who's service. But, you know, we do a lot of gigs like that, or people are still there. I can see how the laws are different. So I play there every weekend until 10 o'clock. And
yeah.
It's cool and scary at the same time, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
I also like to live dangerously. But nevertheless, I hope everybody gets better out there real soon. I got a few friends that are really sick now, and like
how's this guy's the music Giuliano guys, are they?
Greg posted today. He's doing better. But yeah. he had his first night of sleep without the oxygen.
Yeah.
There was an icon that passed away, you know, Kenny Jeremiah.
I heard about
that. Both of him, and that was shocking. And my friend Mario, brother Matt, is in Penn intensive care. I hope he can get through this.
Yeah.
It's scary. He's 50 years old and, you know, 52. I hope it all goes away, you know. I'll take the vaccine. I think I got it already.
You have a personal vaccine.
Yeah. All right.
Listen, what can we do? We have nothing.
Well,
no.
Let's do a song.
Let's do a song.
That's a
good
idea.
Let's do something. Let's do something we all know. I mean, I could do something if you want.
Well, we kind of did a Beatles song that nobody actually heard, so.
You want to do that one again?
No, let's do another one. Let's do another Beatles song.
You want to do it? What do you want to do?
Let Mike pick it.
Let's Mike do it, yeah.
Let's do it live. I can't get that Bill Riley shit out of my head. I say it every day 10 times, you know. Bill Riley freaks out.
Oh,
I don't have to
do it live. I can't read what it's saying. Fuck it, let's do it live. Sorry about the profanity.
Can you kidding me? Look at the king of profanity over here.
Well, sometimes I curse,
right.
Not all the time.
I don't know who was telling me a story the other night, but somebody was telling me a story like I didn't even know you. There's this guy, Hank Kweder, and I said, no, Ken, you're my buddy. He says this a lot. I said, well, there's a reason for that.
What you got there, man? What's this? You got a bunch of CDs?
I got a
CD bag, man.
It's an Irish CD. I wrote this Irish song in there. Me and Don wrote that.
Yeah, you were telling me you were working on an Irish album or something.
Yeah, a bunch of Irish songs. And just kind of cool because my friend Ray Coleman, who is an Irish singer.
I know him,
He's going to do one of my songs called The Irish Way. And, you know, just it's got some Irish roots. And,
oh, wait, these are songs...
Except for mine.
I know some of these are traditional songs. You know?
Yes.
Where's yours at? Where is it?
It's Son of Ireland.
Oh, we have to do John Lennon. That's right. It's his birthday. So.
Can you do a John Lennon song? Which one would you want to do?
I want to do this one, Watching the Wheels Around.
Oh, yeah. What key?
It's in C.
Okay.
And but you could sing in some of it too.
No, I'll let you do it. You know.
Yeah.
Hey, George, what's up, man?
My buddy George, he was over at my house today doing some.
George. Georgie, please stay. Don't take all the way. Oh hell, John. Oh. People say I'm crazy. What I'm doing. Well, they give me all kinds of advice. Save me from ruin.
FD's G.
When I say that I'm okay, well, they look at me kind of strange. Surely you're not happy now, you no longer play the game. People say I'm lazy, dreaming my life away. Well, they give me all kinds of warnings, designed to invite me. When I say that I'm okay, well, they look at me kind of strange. Surely you're not happy, no longer play the game. Questions lost in confusion. Well, I tell them there's no problem, only solution. When I say that I'm okay, watching shadows on the wall, don't you miss the big time?
is how to let it go. I just had to let it go. John Lennon.
Cool, man.
Thank you.
That's a good one. I came on that 1980 album, right?
That's a Double Fantasy, right?
That's it, yeah. That was produced by Phil Spector, right?
No. Jack Wagner, maybe, or somebody else, one of those guys. Phil Spector, I don't know.
Spector did one of his other.
Yeah, he did a couple. he has a track record of doing a couple Beatles records. And
I knew a girl who dated Phil Spector.
She alive?
Yeah, but her stories concur with the other stories.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, there's a documentary, like when he was in the studio with the Ramones, he pulled a gun on the guys.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so everybody knows the USB was not plugged in all the way. That's why it was going in and out. So we should be okay now.
Okay.
Everyone wants to tell you, you know, yeah. Check Mike's chords. His piano could be out.
Thank God for comment section.
Hey, Anthony Baker.
Yeah.
Your boy, you were just talking about him.
Yeah, man.
He was saying some nice things about Anthony, I got to tell you.
Hello, Anthony. All right. What do you got there? You got something?
No, it's your turn.
Okay. Let's see here.
When I wake up, yes, you know I'm gonna be. I'm gonna be the man that wakes up next to you. When I go out, yes, you know I'm gonna be. I'm gonna be the man. If I get yours, yes, you know I'm gonna be. I'm gonna be the man that's got the job for you. If I hate her, yes, you know I'm gonna be. I'm gonna be the man that's ever next to you. 1, 2, 3, 4. I would walk 500 miles, and I would walk 500 more just to be the man to walk 1,000 miles to fall down at your door. When I come home, yes, you know I'm gonna be the man that's gonna love you. If I go, yes, you know I'm gonna be. I'm gonna be the man that's gonna love you. 1, 2, 3, 4.
That's what this is. The table test. This was a table.
Life is a test.
The table test, man.
Test of
so
life.
Great to have you here, man. This is great.
It's a good idea. Maybe take the life test with Kenn.
Look, man.
I haven't liked that one. No,
hold on. You got that one.
All right.
Me and Mark does it.
Ready?
Wait.
I got one fucking hand. It's Mike Tyson.
Tyson looked good at that. Did you see him a couple weeks ago fighting? He looked good.
Yeah, I missed the fight.
I watched it. I watched it.
No knockouts.
Yeah, but he was fast.
It was a draw. Yeah, okay.
It was not a draw. I watched all eight rounds.
So I haven't heard. What happened?
Tyson came out like a maniac.
Going to fight
Roy Jones just backed up
Ran away the whole time. That's what I heard.
The whole time, yeah. It was almost like he just looked like Tyson's, somebody that you knew would never box. Like, never box.
Tyson
like,
smoked
like he was totally. He was one of the great boxers of all time, Roy Jones, you know? Yeah, and he just looked totally uncoordinated. It was weird.
He hasn't fought in 3 years, but Tyson hasn't fought in like 15.
Yeah, but Tyson took it real seriously. But I think he's doing Evander Holyfield.
Oh, Tyson, Roland Stuck says he did Tyson kicked his ass.
It's true. Right, Roland? That first 3 seconds when he came out.
Hey, Ro.
Hi, Cindy. Anthony Baker thinks we need a drummer.
Why does he have to watch tomorrow?
We're going to put him.
Yeah, you know what? Bring that kid that goes around a circle. Stick it up here somewhere.
Lou Maresca, how you doing, man? What's going on? Lou.
What's going on, man?
What's happening, man?
All right.
What do you got there, Maestro?
Oh, God, I wasn't even thinking because I'm trying to get the audio going.
I mean, I could do something, too.
What's the difference between Bono and God?
There's none.
God don't think he's Bono.
Okay.
Thanks, turn it out for that.
I like that one.
Yeah.
Well, then should we do a song by God then? Ah, oh, there's our drummer.
All right.
Okay, yeah.
Is it getting better? Or do you feel the same? Will it make it easier on you now? You got someone to blame. You said one love, one life, but it's one need in the night. It's one love with each other. Leaves you, baby, you don't care for it. Did I disappoint you?
Yeah.
I'll leave a bad taste in your mouth. You act like you never had love. You want me to go without. Well, it's too late. Tonight, you drag the best out into the light. One, but we're not the same. We get to carry each other, carry each other. Whoa. Have you come here for forgiveness? Have you come to raise the dead? Have you come here to lay Jesus to the lepers in your head? Did I ask too much, more than lots? You gave me nothing, now it's all I got. We're one, but we're not the same. We hurt each other, then we do it again. You say, love is a temple. Love the higher law. Love is a temple. Love the higher law. Well, you asked me to enter in, then you made me crawl. I can't be holding on to what you got when all you got is hurt. One love, one blood, one life. You've got to do what you should. It's one love. With each other, sisters, brothers, to one life, but we're
to carry each other, carry each other. Whoa, 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 whoa.
I was just trying to
do a Kweder trick. I was F minor.
It's a Gronson arrangement.
E minor. That's what you, from that one, like whenever you do gigs, just.
He had a Mick Ronson moment.
Yeah, yeah. Like, pull a trick on me. I don't even know the difference. That's a problem.
Sue Shen wants Mike McCullough's or Mike LeCompt's choice. She just requested.
What's that one?
I like the spaghetti.
McCullough's.
Oh, meatballs. Food.
No. What are you talking about?
What's this?
A song?
He's going to a food menu.
I'm going to have to dedicate a song sometime tonight to Michelle. She wanted to hear Rock and Roll Suicide later on, wherever we do that. But,
what's her Rock and Roll Suicide? Oh, you know what? Paul, that's Paul loves that song.
When he comes up, when Paul Ryan comes up.
Paul Ryan comes in, yeah. He'll be here before. You know.
We got a request for Imagine. Like,
oh, there we go.
That's my cousin Chris.
I do that?
It's only like three. How many questions? What key is it?
We're singing?
I'll sing it. What key is it?
It's C, just like the other song.
Okay, yeah. Is there an F minor in there?
I'm ready to play the other one.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us only the sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. And no religion too. Imagine all the people living life in peace. Say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will live as one. Imagine no possession. I wonder if you can. No need to greet or hunger. A brotherhood of men. Imagine all the people living all the world. You make hay, I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. Someday you'll join us, and the world will be as one. Sir Chris Wetzler. Oh, yes. Cousin Chris.
Yeah, 40 years
was your cousin
ago.
Chris one of them?
Yeah, cool. Chris Wetzler, yeah.
All 40 right. years ago, I remember. I'm sure you remember that day.
I remember the moment, but I was living in 8th and Fitzwater. It was fucked up. It was just unbelievable, just impossible to process, you know, when you found out, you know.
I want to play this on some shit. Okay. All right. I never liked it ever since the Hooters used it, but I don't know.
Just kidding. She would do a Hooters song.
I'd like to thank Rob Hyman. He said it with this and that.
You know, the other day you were talking about Irish tunes and stuff, man. And you were kind of controlling the conversation. I was trying to tell you that I wrote a song that could fall under the Irish. It sounds like an Irish tune.
Do it.
You want to hear it? It's only three chords.
That's all the best ones are.
So think about this. Listen to this. In case. C, F, and G. Are you ready? Okay. I went down to Motto Town to see my best friend Bobby. Bobby said he's not around, he's got a brand new jobby. Froggy said that Bobby's dead, he choked on the corn of a cobby. What kind of job can you drink on the job when you're drinking on the job on a jobby? What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? Hey! What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? Hey! What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? Hey! What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? Every time I do a gig, it seems so very obby. People think I need a drink to do a better jobby. Suddenly I'm surrounded by drinks coming from the nearest lobby. What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on the job on a jobby? What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on the job on a jobby? Hey! What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on the job on a jobby? Hey! What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on the job on a jobby? Hey! What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on the job on a jobby? Michael Lecompt on solo! Sure, I know what for I do this to my body. My doctor says I seem okay, but my liver's rather spotty. Either way, I'm on my way, heading towards the next big party. What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? Hey! What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? Hey! What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? Hey! What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? Brother Solo by Michael! To my body. My doctor says I seem okay, but my liver's rather spotty. Either way, I'm on my way, heading towards the next big party. What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? Hey! What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? Hey! What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? Hey! What kind of job can you drink on a job when you're drinking on a job on a jobby? Bobby, corn on the... That sounded great. It was cool. That's what this is all about. All
right, so...
Table.
Phil Smithberg's here.
Hey, Phil.
Georgia Getz. Georgia. Hi, Georgia.
Hi, Georgia.
Hey, Georgia.
There's Debbie Dan Ward. Look at all these people coming in.
It's great, man.
All these people that Michael is bringing in.
I can never tell how many people are looking, you know.
Turn up the melodica.
Turn it up. Who's next? Who's going?
It's my turn.
Mike, okay.
Oh, boy.
Okay.
All right, get it.
You got ready? Hold on.
Right out here. It's not the first time. They're ganging up on me. The cuckoo's nest. I could send this out to Georgia and Michelle, if I can remember it.
Hey, Georgia.
It's a colorful small affair. To the guy with the mousy hair. But to mommy is yelling no. And the daddy is told it to go. But to friend is nowhere to be seen. So she walks through a sunken dream. To the sea, to the clear as you. And she's up to the silver screen. But the film is a saddening bore. Cause she's looked it 10 times or more. She can spit in the eyes of fools. As I ask her to focus on sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at those cavemen go. In the freakiest show. Take a look at the law man beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, wonder if you'll ever know. In the best-selling show is a life on Mars. It's a god-awful small affair. It's a god-awful small affair.
Sorry. Fuck. Sorry. To the god. Hey, when you hit the wrong button.
I like that version of it.
Sorry, Mike.
That's all right. It's the way it goes when you do it live. Fuck, I'll do live.
Were you lip singing the whole time, Mike? Somebody called.
I knew these guys had the technical side of it together.
Well, I thought we did.
Someone called. They're calling this a rock star right. Convention here.
Right? Yeah, sure. Right on the second verse.
Okay.
Sorry.
It's on America's trucks and brown. It's on America's trucks and brown. Cause Mickey Mouse has grown up a cow. Now the workers are struck for fame. Cause Lennon's on sale again. See the mice and their million hooves. From my people to the Norfolk broads. Who pretend you is out of bounds. To my mother, my dog and clowns. The film is a sounding bore. Cause I wrote it 10 times or more. It's about to be written again. As I ask you to focus on sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at those cavemen go. Isn't the freakiest show? Take a look at the long man beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, wonder if you'll ever know. And the best-selling show is a life on Mars. Oh yeah. It's the best you're gonna get.
That was great.
That's a tremendous song, man.
Life on Mars. Life at Smokey Joe's.
All right, man.
Me and Kenny are going to write something in this next shutdown together.
I'm ready, just let me know.
The last shutdown, I was telling Mark that was, you know, we were running off the rails a little bit, and I was recording the White Album over.
Right.
In the basement for a couple of days.
You were doing the White Album on your own?
Yeah,
you know, in your own
way. Down there, taking apart shit, recording, everything, you know, multitasking.
Yeah.
Till they got me.
Till they caught you on the White Album.
Yeah.
A White Album.
I definitely want to do a, you know, like a Rolling Stone tonight sometime.
You should do it now. I get the harmonica. I have a harmonica.
I'm playing the organ.
You can play the organ? Al Cooper. Yeah. Al Cooper!
Yeah, it's a great story.
Oh, okay, I know we're going. All right. I was like, what the hell are we doing? Never mind. Oh, wait, wait, you're on your camera, sorry.
Yeah.
There you go.
Okay, okay.
Anticipation, man.
Put some on top. Caramel apple. It's real caramel.
Okay, I'll check it out.
There it is.
Okay, cool. Okay.
Thank you, Bobby, for that.
Yeah. Where'd that come from?
This girl, Bobby, was, her and her husband gave me a box the other night because I...
Did he make them?
No, I stole them from her house on a holiday in Oktoberfest, and I told her, I said, man, it's a great taffy. So she gave me a box of them, but you'll enjoy this apple, caramel apple pop. I just want to show you. Okay. That's some caramel. And when you get done the caramel...
Okay, yeah.
I got one for you.
You got to be careful with those things, man. You know. Wow, it's fun. Nice. Makes you laugh. Makes you have a smile or two, you know.
I'm a hack. I'm a hack, but never less anybody. So is Al Cooper.
request for more John Lennon, so.
You got another? Yeah, definitely.
Jack Lemmon?
Huh?
Jack Lemmon?
You know a Jack Lemmon?
Jack, I know some Jack Lemmon. I could do Jack Lemmon.
Jack Lemmon
song.
Jack Lemmon vodka?
Jack Lemmon vodka. I was doing Lemmon vodka last week, man.
Yeah. And was that when you stop?
Because I drank the next day. I was in the Acme. It was a long story. Thursday wasn't a good day. Was it?
Got a nice audience here. A limited audience.
Hey, man, guys.
Turn out.
I think we've exceeded the amount of people
representing East
here.
Falls.
We got social distancing.
Don't let the mayor know how many people are in here.
Yeah,
There's less than 10 people, so we might be in trouble.
There was 9 tickets available. They were $1,000 a piece. They sold. You know, I think it was like the fastest show I ever made. 6 seconds.
How about Dylan sold all those songs for 300 million, Bob Dylan? See that?
300 million.
300 million, yeah.
You know, all of them.
Let me tell you something. I got 8, 9 kids. I don't know. I got to spend some dough. All
right. Yeah. I'm realizing, like, all the Beatles songs I know are McCartney songs. They're not, I mean, I know them, but.
I heard them. Like, John, you don't know any specific. You know, I know you know.
I know it, but I don't sing it.
And Help is a John Lennon song.
You sing that. I don't sing Help.
Okay, but you know it.
I'm sorry. I only sing Paul McCartney songs. Okay, there you go with that.
Do you know, like, I'm just fucking around a little bit. Silly Love Songs.
Yeah, that's a good one.
We should do that one a little later on. You know, do you know how to play that? Do you know, can you play that?
What's wrong with that? I like some blow. So here I go again. Doesn't come at all. I only know that when I'm in it. Love is a city. Love is a city. Love is a city. People want it out enough for silly love songs. songs. What's wrong with that?
That's the way it goes. That's a punk version of it. Nevertheless, it's the way it goes.
That's a clever tune.
Did it live.
What you'll notice when you play with Kenn, it starts out as the original, it turns into the punk version as the song goes on.
I changed the lyrics up. I was like, some people think I'm gonna know the silly drug songs.
And if the sun refused to shine, I would still be loving you. The mountains crumble to the sea. There would still be you and me.
That was Shadow Zeppelin there. Woo! That was a request, by the way. Somebody put that up.
Yeah. I was like, my girl was saying this, that, you know, we play gigs all our life. Is, you know.
Chris O'Brien says he's looking forward to when Galuccio can join us. Me too. I'm looking forward to that too.
That'd be amazing.
We're inspired by the crowd at a lot of gigs. And like at these football games and these sports events, they got to play like, you know, they should green screen people in that for us to see, because it looks so weird when you watch these football games, especially the highlights, like it's an exhibition game, you know. Like,
oh, wait.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah, totally. Yeah.
Because, you know, it's feet off the ground.
Lacking a pistol.
Yeah.
That's our crowd right here. We got that going on right now.
There's our crowd.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where's that at?
That was here a few. That was the last night that we were a lot of people. Now it looks like that.
It's quiet.
That's what the government's telling us.
Super spreader.
It's quiet. I think I got a request.
We got Zima. We had somebody requested. Hello, Jimmy, it's me.
And Jimmy the Beanstalk.
Gotta fake that for you.
Mm-hmm. Going with the Dylan Flowers.
That's a tough one.
Hey Tommy, what's going on, man?
Yeah.
At least half it.
Think, but something's wrong. There's something here that doesn't last too long. Maybe I shouldn't think of you as mine. Seeing you or seeing anything as much as I do you, I take for granted that you're always there. Just don't care. Sometimes I cannot sing all the way through. It's important to me that you know you are free, 'cause I never was that great for you.
But
that's all right. Todd
Rundgren. How would one say, too many chords?
Oh, you.
lower. What's to say?
See, I start that a half step lower and then modulate to the regular key, so it doesn't hurt as bad.
I'll take an SAT for that.
Somebody wants Lars Guns and Money.
I could do that. Yeah, Lars Guns and Money. See,
Lars Guns and Kweders. There we go.
Lars Guns and Kweders.
Okay.
Tape, it's already a tape recorded applause, that real?
It's just like a radio show. It's cool.
Does somebody even know what tape recorded means? I mean, like, we do, but I'm like, tape, using tape.
Oh, it's just funny when I'm with my kids and, hey, could you do me a favor? Could you tape that for me? And they go, what? Can you tape, you know, I'm sorry, you know, DVR it. They go, what?
Yeah, it's a different, yeah.
Betamax.
You recorded for me? Oh, okay.
A lot of stuff. See, things have moved so quick now that what was brand new 2 years ago is already gone.
Oh, I know. Well, you saw the, you know, we had the Baruch shows that came out on DVDs.
Michelangelo.
And Blu-rays.
Yeah.
And I got one in the mail. I'm like, oh, great. I don't have anything to play it on.
There's no slot. There's no slots anymore or any of that.
No, there's nothing. Yeah.
I got some old school stuff in my basement I dug up, you know.
You got what?
Old school devices. There's just crap in everywhere. But yeah, I can find DVD players and CD players. Crazy shit in there already, too. I'm plugging it off.
Any 8-track players?
No, I don't have an 8-track. I do have some 8-tracks that make them things, and I have a cassette player. And believe it or not, there's a lot of stuff on, I have on cassette. I had the 8-track cassette for a while, and that broke, and I ordered another one, eBayed it, the Tascam 688.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I got 3 of them at my house now, and the last two I ordered, they didn't work great, because I got good songs on them, but I got to take the masters for it, try to do to the digital era, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Digitize or whatever, just listen to them, and you learn them.
Someone told put Ken Kweder's Greatest Hits on an 8-track a few years ago, like a little bit too late, but they're like 10 8-tracks somewhere in the universe.
Back to the future.
Yeah. Hey, Maureen's here. Maureen Basher there. Hey, Maureen.
Hey, Maureen.
The fable of the Uber driver.
Yeah, we need to finish that.
It's in there somewhere.
I got my glasses. Hold on, I do got glasses.
Yeah.
I can read that now. Wow.
Can you see it?
Yeah, man. I ran over my glasses like 31 years ago. I backed over them. I didn't get them for like till like 3 months ago.
Well, are these prescriptions you got on?
Yeah.
Let me try this.
Prescriptions and bifocals.
No, you gotta get dizzy, man.
No, see.
Holy shit! I'm already. I swear to God.
You can't get dizzier.
I mean, like the what do you call it? The you know, when you go into like a carnival and they have the mirrors are bent. That. Man, everything looks bent, man.
I've been seeing the world through rose-colored glass for about.
You know what it is?
Years.
I think it's the bifocal fighting the prescription.
Yeah.
Like the bifocal at the bottom.
Yeah.
Is the geography of the bifocal.
They look good on you, though.
Check it out. Like the safe distancing.
Yeah, a clear pair too.
Wow.
You lost that for a while too.
Jeez. I lose everything.
It's like
things are bent. Yeah, 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 yeah.
That's what she said.
It's like virtual reality. It's like virtual reality.
I hate when I wear it because it is reality.
Yeah.
But I've been noticing, laying on the couch watching TV, I can read the bottom now. And you know, when you do that, you can't see it, but when I do that, I can't. But if I'm reading something here, it's bifocals. You know, you got to get with learn how to do it.
Yeah, yeah. You know. I got a lot of stories about glasses. You know, we'd be here till 8 a.m. tomorrow. You don't want to know that.
Big glasses.
I remember one time I went to see this doctor. And I had eaten like a fucking bulb, a huge bulb of garlic the night before, and he was measuring mine to fit the frames on my face to make them perfect. And I didn't realize I was breathing into his face. And he this is unbelievable. Like it was like a bulb of raw garlic, right? And then he kept talking to me about the integrity of the fit. Yeah. Then he said, "Get the fuck out! Just get out of here."
Well, I have to tell you, there's been many a nights when we've come up being played, and you've had the raw garlic.
The garlic, yeah.
I feel sorry for that guy.
Yeah,
it's good for you, though, right?
But I cut way back. But I used to eat a lot of raw garlic.
It's good for you.
Anytime my hair would start to go gray, I eat a lot of garlic and went back to dark color.
Right.
But now it's failed. It's not even helping anymore. I'm just falling apart. Yeah, that's it. The great piano guards, eight tracks with the time. Who's next? I don't know. Am I next or are you next?
Good
you
record.
Just did Rocket Man.
Yeah.
You did.
You do.
I'll do it. Someone went to hear New Hampshire, which is...
Oh, yeah. Do that.
That's my cousin, Chris. Chris, like, it's only a couple chords. It's like A minor, D, G. He's like... It's like... This is the song I wrote about you. It's like... When people know your face and they've all heard your name. And slap hello at you, but they all feel the same. You can't place the face or why they ever came. To give you credit for some cards you never played. Don't you know someone manufactured someone true? Straight from New Hampshire. Clouds might disappear, but the faceless voice gets no more skeptical of what she hears. This minute of truth is just too weak to wash the smears that have hidden your soul from yourself for oh so many years. Don't you know someone manufactured someone true? Straight from New Hampshire. Straight to you. Someone manufactured you, straight from New Hampshire, straight to you. No, I can't help things beyond my control. Some people think they know my very soul. It's just an image that they got from years ago, from something they read or a story they might be told. It's someone manufactured, someone true, straight from New Hampshire, straight to you. Someone manufactured, someone true, straight from wherever you are, straight to you. Lyrics that they can apply to you, man. A story they were told.
So Roland Stuckey says, have Mike play Louisiana Wind.
Oh, okay.
Woo. Jesus. Hey, Joseph. Not a chorus in this song. I'll try it.
Fuck, I'll do it live.
It's called Louisiana Wind, and some co-writers on this. Dennis Vitalski, Mike Caruso, and Tamara Champlin. Thank you guys for your input in the song, and haven't played it in a while, but it's on a CD.
Thought I was strong enough, thought I could let you go. I took a Greyhound bus down a long dusty road, never far enough to let my morning light. I'll be finally out.
forgot some of the words, but thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Nice song. It's a tremendous tune, man.
Wow. Get that on iTunes.
Yeah. I've heard, I did look that up a while ago. It's a great song.
Yeah, we played some fun gigs together. I was telling somebody a story about the New York gig last night. It was a monumental gig for me.
That was incredible.
Because I was a little under the doctor's influence of street doctors, nevertheless.
Yeah.
And you were under the influence of some stuff, too.
I was under something. Yeah.
Yeah, but those people were great. And then,
they loved you, man. It was like nuts.
Then across the street.
Yeah.
It was wild.
You're like, you were videotaping stuff with your camera.
I got some good stuff on that videotape. I lost that phone. That was great. Maybe it's for the better.
It's probably good you lost
it. That was a night.
Probably good you lost that phone.
I'll tell you, this night, this party was wild. And then it was over 2 o'clock, and we went out, and this after our era on that street, wherever that was.
Yeah, it was a Slattery's. We played Slattery's.
Oh, okay.
On that second floor.
Man.
Yeah.
Some good stuff that night.
We had a third guy with us. I think it was a bass player, maybe?
Somebody, I don't remember. Yeah.
And he drove me over, I crashed over his uncle's house or something. I was getting pretty high, and cab drivers were going by. I said, I feel like there's corpuscles, going by, you know? So I saw him a couple years later. He goes, I keep thinking about those corpuscles.
I'll tell you what, it was like, I was like, this is crazy, man. People hanging out, man, and could do stuff and go on the street and stay up till 6 in the morning.
It was great, man.
Oh, you know? Definitely.
Then you and I talked a few days later, and you said, Ken, I think I'm not going to drink anymore. So. Something like that, I don't know. But you had a great time.
I think someone dosed me.
Yeah, what time did you get home? Like 8 a.m. or the next?
Yeah, it was not a good thing when I got home.
Yeah. Yeah. But it was fun. It was fun. You had your whole group, there was a whole group of alumni, Penn alumni. They were surrounding him. You were just telling these unbelievable.
They were smart kids.
But the stories you told them, they were so amazing. I mean, because you were the real Keith Richards or something.
I was close to death that night, but I made it through it. That was a scary time. Right.
My
friend Trent Tim with me drove me up there, and
yeah,
yeah, whew, that was a wild thing. I mean, when you tell these gigs, these people are so loyal to you for years, and they must have been out of college about maybe 10.
A couple of years.
Yeah, 10 years, because they were
still, still young.
You can tell by the way they were dressed, they had a lot of money.
Yeah, if they were partying, some people, I mean, I could tell you stories that Mark and I did a bunch of.
You go everywhere to do that, right?
Yeah.
San Francisco.
Yeah, we went out to San Francisco, Chicago.
I'm going back to San Francisco.
Wild, man. And it's usually the same. It's usually pandemonium. Remember that show we did in San Francisco 2 years ago? That was nuts. That was almost dangerous.
I think they're all really
dangerous.
They're all really professional people now, making big dollars. And when you come around, they let loose. They get to go back to their college days.
Because we did a gig 2 years ago. We were in San Francisco, and a lot of people work at Silicon Valley. They came to see us to let loose, man.
You got those guys through college.
Yeah, it was pretty wild. Like Silicon Valley. We're like,
you told me
we should try to get gigs in Silicon Valley.
You told me that Elon Musk used to get your beers for you.
He did, because when Greg Davis and I were over there, Elon Musk was in school here in 1992, and he brought beers over to us, the bar back and stuff, back in the day.
Got his arm.
Ask Greg Davis.
That's for a little loan. I'll take care of this whole place for
her. Yeah. Who's next, man? It's your turn, bro.
It's my time. Listen to you guys.
We're just telling stories.
What am I going to do?
We could tell a lot of stories, man.
Tell a story when I did a gig with Mark, the Bowie gig. It was the rehearsal. It's great. It was fun. It's such a fun gig.
I saw videos of the rehearsal.
That was a fun gig. The rehearsal was better than the gig, actually.
The rehearsal was great.
I got in trouble for not coming to any rehearsals, but I was on a mission for a couple of months there, and I did show up that one rehearsal, the last rehearsal before we did the gig, and... I didn't have the song list, and these guys are kind of like nice guys, they run the Bowie thing, but they gave me a list, and we ran through the songs. It was great. It was a fun read through them. It was all there. Jeffrey Gaines there, that Odie, that band, the guy with the outfit on.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh La La, Ooh La La, and also Alyssa Lee Lewis. It was a lot of great entertainment.
Yeah, man.
Too bad you weren't there.
Well, I mean, you guys are Bowie. I mean, I love Bowie, but you guys are more Bowie-centric.
They asked me to do it, and I'm like, really? Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
I said, yeah, I'll do it. So I didn't. I wanted to show up for the rehearsals, but I just couldn't. Somewhere was missing.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
MIA.
Yeah, but you did it. It was sold out, right? That fucker was sold out.
It was out.
What's the capacity of that place?
1,200.
1,200, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but it was, I mean, it was sold out.
I'm saying it was sold out. Yeah.
It was 1,400 there.
Yeah, yeah.
14, it was in the front.
It's on an original kick, so.
Yeah.
I've been waiting all winter for it to come, anticipating all the dating, good, clean fun. The oceans, the lotions glistening on the sand. While we were crashing, waves came crashing all the way from France. Cause I'm on the beach in the summer sun. I'm so happy, I'm so excited, this is happening. Boardwalk walking, people talking, all the rides are free. The growls, the gals bathing in the bright sunshine. Socks, no more time clocks, it's summertime. I can't be reached cause I'm on the beach in the summer sun. In the summer sun. Sunshine, no more knee socks, no more time clocks, it's summertime. I can't be reached cause I'm on the beach in the summer sun. In the summer sun. In the summer sun.
Is that an E with a C sharp on top, like when you did the thing?
Yeah, there's a couple I couldn't tell over there. It was fancy chords.
You know, I gotta ask you guys, I never asked you a question, It's like, did you take, well, no, you obviously went to school for music, obviously. Did you, like, take lessons when you were younger?
No, but I was in the school band. I played sax.
So you were kind of like, people were teaching you stuff.
Well, I always thought I learned, oh, kid, I had a learning disability, of anything, or listening disability, I got one of them. But nevertheless, I always try to learn every day something. But as I've gone along, I had music in the family, so there was a lot of listening and
like
stuff.
The language, you got a language.
And I would tell a story where, you know, I was taking in the school band, I was playing saxophone, and the saxophone teacher was discussed with me, and this ends up the saxophone teacher is one of the best in the world. His name's Larry McKenna. He's great. But,
Larry, yeah.
But Larry McKenna was your, really?
Yeah. Wow. And I used to have to come in now with Jeff Beck, so I was playing guitar because I was a guitar player. But one time, I went to a lot of concerts. One time, at the Ethical Society. Remember that, where that was?
I was almost arrested down there, yeah.
I went there, and my brother Jack, rest his soul, was into jazz, and you know, passed away a couple years ago. He was a drummer. He would get me into this, like, take me to this jazz concert, this concert he couldn't go to, which was funny. So I was about 13, I guess. We went down there and stood in the alley. We had some tickets to the Jazz Messengers, Heartbreaking. So these guys would come down the alley, like five guys. It was pretty tough, you know, pretty big. And they came up to us, and they go, "You coming in?" And it was all the Jazz Messengers, you know, Ron Carter, Art Blakey. And I didn't really know at the time, but...
What year is this? '75.
So I went down in the basement with them, and we smoked a bunch of opium. Then they went up and played, and, you know, Herbie Hancock was in the band.
Holy shit.
Wayne Shorter. Wow. So the music was very hard to digest, but... He always did come in on the one, but I smoked opium with Art Blakey, so I don't like to drop names. Paul McCartney told me not to drop names, but you know, Art Blakey got to drop that.
I know that basement room, I know that.
You know that?
I know the Ethical Society.
How long did you play sax? How long did you play sax?
I still play it.
Oh, really?
I think I play it, yeah.
No, I played in 6th and 7th grade, and that was my first instrument.
I played
my first
instrument on the bridge, the Walt Whitman Bridge, you know, right? No, I can learn something, like, I learned all the Bowie solos, of course, you know.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, Soul Love, and, you know, there's a couple other ones in there, Young Americans, you know, wow. Determined to learn that stuff. But I did have some, Larry McKenna was the great, but at the time I didn't realize who he was, and, you know, he's world-renowned, this guy.
Yeah.
Wow.
So whenever I'm talking to somebody, they go, "Oh, you play sax? Who you study with?" Larry McKenna.
Yeah.
Wow, I didn't realize who it was, so I was way out of high school, and I ran into him a few times. Great guy. One for Larry McKenna.
I did a gig there the same year. The original Secret Kids, the first version. And we had this wild crowd to come see us.
And it was kind of a laid-back place.
It was a laid-back place. Our crowd was really fucking nuts. Like, Southwest Philly, everybody from Southwest Philly. And everybody showed up in, like quarts of beer. No six, like, just quarts of beer. Like one person came with 20 quarts. And at the Ethical Society, the entire place was blasted, right? And then somebody in the audience noticed that somebody on stage was playing a saxophone, and the person in the audience realized they had just been burglarized 2 weeks prior in Southwest Philly, and their saxophone was stolen. They realized the guy on stage with me with the saxophone had the saxophone that was stolen. So the guy in the audience decided to take justice in his hands at the Ethical Society. Well, I'm singing with the Secret Kids, and I got pictures of this shit. This guy goes up, and he's beating the shit out of the guy with the saxophone, like, right in, punching him in the mouth. And then, like, all of a sudden, someone calls the cops, and the whole Ethical Society is surrounded by the cops. They come in, bust the show.
Unethical.
Right? And, you know, that was unethical. So then, like, you know, we were, like, thrown out of there, and, like, 6 months later, I booked another gig, and I got back in.
Is it still there?
I was just in there. It's one of my favorite. I was there in November. I went in there.
Yeah, I was in there a couple of times. I saw, like, Papa it. Joe Jones, Philly yeah. Joe Jones. I mean, all these guys, these drummers. I saw them.
Love that place, man.
Jack Bass Masters. I did smoke some opium with those guys. And they went on a play after that. And I could comprehend that. Mary Had a Little Lamb at the time, and they were playing some serious stuff, you know.
Yeah, yeah. That Ethical Society, really cool, man. It's at that Rittenhouse Square. Yeah. Hey, Marie, how are you there? She came to see a lot of your shows down the shore, Marie. I don't know if you know Marie.
Yeah.
She came down and saw a lot of your shows. Karen Murphy, you were at the Ethical Society. She was there.
Becky.
The Karen Murphy was there in 1975. Eddie Foy. I think Eddie brought the 20 quarts of beer in. It was nuts.
20 quarts. What kind? Ballantine?
Huh?
Ballantine?
I think it was Ortlieb's or something.
Ortlieb's. My dad
back in the day, where was
beer.
Or Peels.
Schlitz.
Hello, Karen. Oh, my God. She's there. Karen's what? She got a true story. She was there. What do we got next? We could just tell stories all fucking. It's a Johnny Carson show on steroids.
You're correct, sir. You're correct.
Got to get Ed McMahon in here. Bring him back.
Take him out.
I think between you two, guys, we'll be like, "I was there. Yeah. I was there for that."
Yeah. I think the craziest story you ever told. Weren't you in New York during 9/11?
Yes.
You were there that story. Tell that later on.
No, no. Tell it now.
Tell it now. It's really.
Oh, I'll get that live. Well, let me try to
do it live.
Fuck it, we'll do it live. Let me try this. my girl's out there listening, and she'll back me on this. So what happened was, this is a true story. Remember, just went to this big Italian wedding in Ocean City, Maryland. To make a long story short, the guy, rest his soul, Johnny G, he's a drummer who was sitting on the other side of the table, Pat passed away 10 years ago, maybe. And he was bragging about this. He liked to brag about a lot of music stuff. And I walked into the wedding, and I was kind of sober for a while. And I said to the bartender, I said, yeah, you have O'Doul's? She goes, hell yeah. I said, well, give me a glass of whiskey. And so I drank a couple glasses of whiskey. And at the table, he was at the table, and Michelle was next to me, and she was over there. And I just got this tomato on this end of the spoon. I just wanted to fire it right at him. But what happened was, when he fired, I know it went airbound somewhere. So I went right to the bathroom, went in the bathroom, washed my face, and this little kid comes in. He's like, I'm like, what's going on there? He goes, oh, my families are fighting, but somebody threw a tomato at my grandma and hit her right here.
People, and they're all spread out all over the place. So we do the wedding, and just to make, remember, she's not dancing with her father because her father passed away. Okay, we do the thing, and she's dancing with her brothers, and go on. Wedding goes great. I go home, you know, no big deal. So I'm talking to somebody who's a friend of the bride and the groom and everything else. How was it? Oh, it was great. And she starts telling me, she goes, well, that was the daughter of the pilot from the second plane. And I'm like, what? So he was the pilot. He's from Westchester. As a matter of fact, he was like the captain of the football team.
Went into the building?
The one, yeah. Yeah. And I was like, are you kidding me? She goes, oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And so, you know, that was the big, and I had no idea while I was there at this wedding. No idea.
It's incredible. Yeah. Yeah.
So she was the daughter of the pilot for the second plane.
You can't believe it. That close to that.
Yeah. No, it was like,
insane. Oh, yeah.
And they said there was no way.
She was probably young, right?
I don't know. She might have been like a baby. She was like a baby. Yeah.
Wow.
So, yeah. Five or six.
I was like, of course, he's like a hero because he's got a statue outside the west of the football stadium. Maybe it's because he was like the captain of the football team.
Yeah.
He was like a quarterback and all that nine stuff. So I was like, I couldn't believe it. I was like, wow.
Incredible. You know, when you get to be that
horrible loss.
Yeah. So, okay. Enough sad stuff. Let's do something happy.
It's Johnny Carson. I've been working on the railroad. I've been working on the railroad. It's my turn. Who's your turn? Who's the last person to play?
Kate May? What's that?
You just did a... You did a...
All right, there's obviously a conversation going on without us. Let's see. Remember me.
We could get with that a little bit.
Okay, so... I'm going out to read. Remember
the railroad
me.
Tracks.
But now it makes me cry. Railroad tracks.
It's like, that's the... I'm a telephone
player. Kathy, why are you saying Kate May? I don't understand. Small World 5.
I think telephone Paul, he wants...
Okay.
Remember that?
I'm really good. Sweet Caroline, really?
Yeah. Railroad tracks or... Okay.
Where we begin. He doesn't see.
I can follow you.
We're not going to see you.
No. Three.
or four or five. And when I heard her chin rolls off my shoulder, how can I hurt when I'm with you? Touching on, reaching out. Request. Greatest show ever. Look, greatest show ever.
See George go, so good.
All right, George, what's going on? Drinking a scotch.
Ken is alcohol free tonight. This, you know.
I'm not drinking tonight, sir.
You guys suck.
Well, you're drinking.
Yeah, I'm alone. I'm alone up here.
I am fucking totally sober.
Paul, I need help. Yeah. Can I have another one, please?
You know what it's like for me
more,
to be sober?
Please.
Can you say more? Do you know what it's like for me to be sober? Fucking painful. You're sober.
I'm just smoking weed.
All right. What is Back Company Silver, Blue, and Gold?
Guess we. That's a pill company, I think so. Yeah.
Somebody wants to hear that. This is the second time. Steve Thompson wants to hear.
Oh, geez, I'm doing a bit after.
Silver, Blue, and Gold.
So look at this. Ken and Mike Strait, it must be a full moon.
Who said that?
Rollins.
I got it.
Rollins, hey man.
I got my Snoop Dogg.
George says, what? No alcohol? Break out the quartz? Mark drinks alone.
You know what? I'm going to go back.
Yeah, with nobody else.
I should go back to quartz. I remember, George, you used to drink quartz.
Yeah, you know when I drink alone? I prefer to be by myself.
Oh, good old George, man.
Well, here's to you guys.
Thank you.
You suck.
you know.
Although after this session here, I thank you for inviting me to this. I mean,
this is fun, isn't it? It's kind of fun.
I love it. It's great. Yeah, and there's a couple of guys out there. Is it Tom and Matt? Or is it Matt or Mark or
Matt?
Yeah, they got a couple bones rolled. We're gonna have a smoke it on it.
They're gonna smoke.
Oh wait, what was the what was the
Suicide.
Suicide.
Yeah. Play some guitar on it too.
That's a great song.
Paul, this one's gonna be for you.
Yeah.
Let me see, I'm gonna look up the chords.
I gotta look it up because it's been a long time since I played this song.
We're all looking up the chords. What's it called?
Rock and roll.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
No, don't.
I got a message.
Oh yeah, that one.
I send this out to Michelle. She's watching. Let me see.
I'll try not to hear
Dominic
the song.
Dominic Lebar Show. You remember he had that song?
Yeah. There it is. All right.
We wish everybody out in Facebook land could join us here. But you can't, unfortunately. What are you doing, Sue?
Okay. I just got a text. I can't text her shit. But this is for Michelle out there, and she just texted me at 8:51. You used 5 glasses in the house the time you were up. Which was that? An hour. Come on, dude. Thanks. I'll clean that glass up when I get home. 100% unnecessary.
What's 5 glasses?
Yes, I dirtied 5 glasses.
Oh, wait, during the day. Let me just see what I do. That's another.
Come over, we'll have a use up glass party.
Oh, I am beyond that.
I love you. This is for you. All right? To watch.
Didn't you have that? Remember that you brought that guitar that you made that day?
Yeah, yeah.
Covered all in silver with the star.
I was up for a couple of days that night. I was up for a month that night.
We had this great rehearsal doing for this Bowie show. He came in and he crushed it. I mean, I was like, this is going to be great. He comes in, he's got a different guitar, an electric guitar, he's got all this shit. I'm like, uh-oh.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
It's good, though.
It was still great. No, it was just a little different from rehearsal.
Rehearsal was really cool because you guys were playing all day. It was tight, not giving in. I was the last night at Midweight, and I ate some pizza, and Eagles lost that day.
Oh, yeah, that's
playoff
right.
Day, and great studio, great people, great band, and you're the only one I really knew in the whole band. Not even know the guys around or anything.
Yeah.
I just met them and nice guys. Thank you guys for having me there, and that was it. But the Rockwell Suicide, I said to Lance out there, I said, Lance, can you look like you can catch? Right? He said, I catch. I want to throw your guitar right in this break of the song, and I threw the guitar, but then I had to stop because I got lost place, and we picked it up again. Right? Stop! That's great. Time takes a cigarette, puts it in your mouth. You put on a finger, and another finger, and the cigarette. The wall to wall is calling, it lingers till you forget. Oh no, 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 you're a rock and roll suicide. You're too old to lose it. You're too young to choose it. And the clock waits salvationly on your song. You walk past the cafe, but you don't eat when you live too long. Oh no, 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 you're a rock and roll suicide. Shed bricks are stalling as you stumble across the road. Day breaks instead, so you're heavy home. Don't let the sun bless your shadow. Don't let the blue flow drive your mind. You're so natural, religiously unkind. Oh no, love, you're not alone. You're watching yourself, but you're too unfair. You got your head all tangled up. If I can only think you care. Who you been, no matter when or where you seen. All the life seen the lots of ways you play. I had my share of you with blame. You're not alone. Turn on with me, and you're not alone. Give me your hand.
Thank you.
Incredible, man.
That was pretty close. Alcohol suicide. That's a good one.
You don't know five years, do you?
Yeah.
All right. This is the one that's for Paul.
Okay, five years. Okay.
Hold on. I got the intro.
It's right here, buddy. It's right there. Look.
See it?
Pushing through the market square, so many mothers sighing. Loser just come over. We had 5 years left of trying. New sky wept and told us Earth is really dying. Cried so much his face was wet. Then I knew he was not lying. I had telephones, opera house, favorite melodies. Saw boys and toys, legend eyes and TVs. I painted like a warehouse, had no room to spare. Had to count so many things I saw, everything there. Somebody people, all the nobody people, all the doors are people. Tiny children, if the black hand had pulled her off, I think she would have killed them. This guy wept and told us Earth was really dying. Cried so much his face was wet. Then I knew he was not lying. I heard telephones, opera house, favorite melodies, all boys and toys, like IMDBs. I'm brain on diverse.
Hey.
Girl, my age went off it. Kicked some tiny children. Hit the black and the pulled her off. I think she would have killed them. Soldier with a broken arm. And stares to the wheels of the Cadillac. Cop knelt to kiss the feet of the priest. And the queer threw up at the sight of that. Think I saw you in an ice cream parlor, drinking milkshakes cold and long, smiling and waving and looking so fine. Don't think you knew you were in this song. But it was cold and it rained and I felt like an actor. And I fought a mob and I wanted to get back there. Your face, your race, the way that you talk. I kiss you, you're beautiful, I want you to walk. We got 5 years stuck on my eyes. 5 years, what a surprise. 5 years, my brain hurts a lot. 5 years, that's all we got. We got 5 years stuck on my eyes.
5 years,
what a surprise. 5 years, my brain hurts a lot. 5 years, that's all we got. We got
5 years
stuck on my eyes.
5 years,
what a surprise.
5 years,
my brain hurts a lot.
5 years,
that's all we got.
5 years. 5 years
stuck on my eyes.
5 years.
That's tough to play drums like that and say this on. Sorry about that. Mixed up a couple of verses there, but fuck it, we do it live.
Yeah, man. I love that early Burley stuff.
Yeah.
I saw the spiders. I saw that.
I know you did. I saw the tour after that. I saw the Diamond Dogs.
It was unbelievable.
Yeah. Old bastard.
Oh, I got thrown out of there too. Like I got back in there. It's the end.
You always seem to get back in.
I was young. You could get back in those days. You know.
One time I saw Kenny playing a gig on South Street. I think it was probably at my buddy's bar. I came in there and I was doing bad stuff at the time, but you did say to me, "Let me taste a little bit of that."
Oh, that I remember that.
Yeah, yeah.
I had to come up to smoke some Kweder. And you know what?
I know, he played bar. So that night, I think, I walked up the street after you left, and my buddy Timmy were walking up the street, and just walking up, and the TLA was playing, and I was into this band, and I was into this guy, this crazy guy, and I looked up, and I'm like, they're playing here tonight. And the door was open, and we walked in, and oh, it was Brian Jonestown Massacre.
Oh, yeah, man.
Anton Newcomer, Anton.
Neat guy, man.
Out of his mind, but.
Yeah.
They had like 10 guitar players. Their encore was they just put all their guitars on their amps and then feedback for 15 minutes. Yeah. Yes!
There's a great. You told me, I watched the documentary on YouTube.
Remember that cat?
He's interesting cat. He's living over in Holland, I think.
Yeah, Brian Jonestown.
Yeah, really smart cat. See what we got here. That's a lot of requests.
Yes, right. Are we still doing 180 North?
Yes, we're Friday.
We are. But you're got to shut down, right?
You got to shut down. But
Michelle's watching.
They're only allowing 30 people in the tent.
Right, but it was overrun, apparently, right? No, oh, you guys were talking about earlier. That's right.
Yeah, there's like 200 people there or something.
So, but it's still open as of now?
Absolutely, yeah.
So, Mike, do your Christmas song. Christmas All Over the World?
Is that right?
Yeah. I got Christmas
songs. If we're going to start doing Christmas songs,
Mariah Carey.
No, don't even.
Michelle, my bad. These are words that go together. Well, Michelle, I love you. I've worn 35 glasses in an hour.
I was waking up, I was a little tipsy.
Joanne, yes, we will be on Facebook Live, but it's 118 North's site, right?
Yeah, but
they're Facebook Live.
You know, I was thinking, why don't I just run it?
No, I'm going to bring my camera. We're going to stream it.
Yeah, because we get screwed.
Nobody watches that fucking channel. All right, 118. Make sure you tip the band. Make sure you tip the and like nobody watches their channel. I was going to actually bring my,
to bring
half decent camera and set it up as well.
Bring the new camera
and do it from your site. Yeah.
Well, you want me to bring the camera back to my house tonight?
Oh, you want to use that one? We'll use that one.
No, I'm asking. I don't even know what camera you're talking about.
Well, we got like 10 of them here.
Let's use your camera. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is like the Beatles.
There are like 7 cameras here.
This is like the Beatles with all these cameras and everything. We did a bunch of John Lennon in the beginning, but we could do more.
Well, if you were here earlier, or if you were watching, you would have seen all the John Lennon we did earlier. But thanks a lot, Paul. Oh, that's right. He's a survivor. He was recovering.
Yes, I'm a survivor. Yeah. Well, you're looking good. You're looking fine.
So this is Christmas.
There we go.
All right.
That's John Lennon's song.
Another year older. Are gone. So Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Let's hope it's a good one without any fear. War is over.
That's a John Lennon song, but we don't know. It's pretty complex.
It's not that complex.
You know what? A lot of people.
Because nobody wants to play it.
Hold on a second. You guys did the David Bowie tribute. I've done like a Bob Dylan tribute. You know what I'm doing next year? A Yoko Ono tribute.
Oh, no.
That'll sell out.
Richie DiCarlo's got that covered. Trust me.
Is he a Yoko Ono kind
of? Oh, he does a Yoko impression that's ridiculous.
Well, then he could be.
He does it doing. What song? He does it doing singing. I forget what he does. Yoko Ono doing meatloaf or something like that. It's fucking hilarious.
Well, then
go back and look, and he goes, he actually did it. He did a Facebook Live thing. And he streamed, you know, this is my solo show. And he actually said he had all this drum stuff and all this amazing stuff that he was doing. And he goes, I had more requests to do this than anything else.
Yeah.
And it was him doing Yoko Ono.
I think I should do
it. It was hilarious.
But you see, that's right down in there. I can put together a Yoko Ono tribute. Richie's the first guy to do it. We'll get some other recruits. You know.
It would probably sell out just to see what you know the people would expect.
And it would be a really short show. That would be great.
If the bartenders wouldn't dig it. Solid, yeah.
Wow.
She disappeared.
Josh Grassi said, I was born on John Lennon's birthday. Seriously, I turned 40 today.
Wow. How about Primal that? Screaming.
Happy birthday, man.
I think Vicky's talking about Richie. All right, you going to do your Christmas song?
Standing in the dock of Southampton, trying to get all into France. Paris, 28 comes out in the sack, and then from the press said, we wish you success, it's good to have the both of your back, gosh, you know it ain't easy, you know how hard it can be, the way things are going, they're going to crucify me, hey, saving all your money for a rainy day, getting all your clothes charity day. Last night, Kenny said, oh boy, when you're young, you can't take nothing but your soul. Finally made a plane into Paris, honeymooning down at the suite. Be down the cold, say, you make it okay. I'll meet you in two balls of rocks, man, cause you know it ain't easy. Know how hard it can be, the way things are going.
Takes a second to fix, you know.
Okay.
Oh, you got that guitar? Okay, yeah. Thanks. Thank you. This is really great, man. Having a good time in our home.
Holy
shit. That's when he plugged
in. We got a good
time at that place.
Finally. Kenny, want to drink?
I'm on the wagon.
He's on the wagon. Do you believe that shit?
I'm going to plug it in, Mike. I've got a doctor's appointment
tomorrow. You get the sniffles, he goes on the wagon.
Well, we're the older guard.
Yeah. It takes some oil.
Older guard. Wow, that sounds nice. Yeah!
Hey, can I get a
request? It might be a little loud.
What do you want to hear?
I don't know how you feel about doing this song, but I always liked heroin. I mean,
we could do that. Yeah.
Wow.
We could do it.
Personally,
we could do it.
Can you turn that down a little bit? You play a little harder than Mike does.
I'm up there.
Yes. Turn it.
Yeah, turn it down. Yeah.
Just a little bit. You play a little harder than Mike does.
I think I'm like an animal on the guitar. Did you know, I remember years ago, I didn't use picks for years. I used to break strings with my fingers. When I was young, I was insane.
He also breaks picks. The only person I've ever known to break picks.
Yeah, but
like, most people, they get them like worn down. He breaks picks.
Well, you know, they wear down when I do end the songs like that. They wear down, but my arm hurts the next thing.
I don't know. It's just something to do with when I was in a crib. That's okay. So a love song. It's a love song. I got mixed up with all the other babies, all the other babies, all the other babies in the same hospital. The irony of my childhood. I met you at a meeting. Met you at a meeting, and I thought that you were at the meeting for the same reason. At the meeting for the same reason, and I was at the meeting too. I lost you at the meeting, lost you at the meeting, and it left me feeling terribly black and empty. I said, doctor, 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 what can I take? What can I take? He said, Kweder, you gotta take some heroin.
Say like, wow, those guys got Mike lecompt to come play keyboard drums.
I'm getting reviews by all the drummers. He sucks.
Wow.
Make it work. We'll do it live.
Just like we rehearsed it. You know, it's great.
Quiet audience out there.
Oh, there's only 10 people here. Sorry, 9 people.
Oh, I got that. You gotta wait. No, you gotta wait and left. See?
Jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell time and jingle bell line. Snowing and blowing in bushes of fun. Now the jingle life has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell swing and jingle bell sing. And I'm the drunk one.
Sorry, we just got caught up.
Dancing and prancing, Jingle Bell Square, in the frosty air. What a bright time, it's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time, it's the swell time to go riding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Makes and the bingle and the jingling beat. That's the jingle bell rock. Come on, get it solo. What a bright time is the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time is the swell time. Riding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and the mingle and the jingling beat. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell rock.
This is the Christmas show.
Oh.
That's nice, man. So who wrote that song? Because those chords are tremendous.
Jimmy Elms. Jimmy
Some Helms. Of those early Christmas tunes have all the tremendous.
What is it? Bobby Helms.
In the drunk tank, an old man said to me, "You won't see another one."
Oh, I love this song.
And then he sang it to me.
You got to sing it, man.
A poor old Mountain Dew that lit my lift into my eyes on you. I came in just a one, 18 to one. I got a feeling it's going to be a good year. And so I sang a song. I'm going to learn the rest of my dreams of you. The last frustration. I could have been someone. So could anyone. Stole my dreams from me when I first met you. I kept them with me, babe. I put them with my own. Can't make it all alone. I built my dreams around you.
Oh, gives me the chills.
The rest of the song's pretty
Tim Williams. Genius. Cheers, my brother.
Is Tim out there?
This is the best I've felt since Saturday.
What? 4 hours, wasn't it?
5.5.
Oh,
but the last hour, neither one of us remember.
Oh, were you drinking? Okay, because I
ended up staying in his basement right where we
you
played.
You were standing the whole time, right?
Yeah.
Holy jeez. Because Jamie and I were watching a good look, the beginning, like the very beginning. Because it started kind of.
Oh, when it was good?
Oh, well, yeah, it was all good. After a while, we couldn't hang in there for like 4 hours.
I'll trade you for something I have in my bag for one of these.
Oh, you want back to the lecompt can?
Just take that. That's yours. It's a gift.
Look at this.
There we go.
That's right. That's right.
Hang on to that thing, man. See?
No, it's jab, jab, jab. Right.
Jab, jab, back.
There you go. I beat Kenny every time with a jab, jab, jab. Right.
Yeah. Right. Jab, jab, jab. Right.
I got a whole lot of puppets here, man. You know how many puppets I got in this building? Lots of puppets. Roland, what's going on?
Okay, I'll take that out.
Okay, thank you,
Crystal Meth.
Thank you, Crystal Meth. Okay.
Look at that.
Good old crystal meth. Heroin and Jingle Bell Rock, two of my favorite holiday tunes. did Johnny get a hold of you? Johnny Good Times. That's Johnny
no.
Good Times.
Oh, is that John? Oh.
Yeah, there. Johnny, yeah. Yeah. That's Mark, Johnny.
The last time you saw Packing In.
I don't know what that is.
Razzles, man.
Are they cool? Is it like gummy bears?
I like razzles, old candy, old gum or something.
Is there salt on them or something?
No. I got gummy bears up.
What do you think all this candy?
Well, a lot of it's pot candy.
Yeah. Do you have gummy bears?
Yeah, it's good. Stony Punch.
Is that like,
Yeah, yeah.
This is what happens with two old rock and roll guys coming sober. They're doing candy. I'm talking about candy.
Hey, hold on a second. Look at it. What's in here? I'll take it home. Because I don't want to. I got to be sober for one. I got to be in good shape for tomorrow.
No thanks. I got alcohol. I'm good.
Yeah. But I'll take this. Are these strong?
Yeah.
Okay, good. I'll take it before I see the doctor.
Oh, wait. Those kind of get candy.
These are the ones. Take one. You go home.
Yeah, I'll take.
I'm gonna. Yeah. What else we got? I'm gonna put this in with the crystal meth.
Some good candy.
Oh, wait. Jamie, can you hold on to this?
Yeah.
Okay, take it. Oh, she loves these, Jamie.
All right, this is what I love this song, and I'm going to hear you do it.
Put on.
he's gonna kick my ass later.
No, I always like that song. I never really sang it. I never sang every other song in the world, but
yeah, every Who song, you know, except for the one I picked to do.
Fuck, I'll do a lot.
That's the kind of show we got going here, man. Anything can fucking go. Fuck it.
Man,
fuck
song.
The rules and regulations.
I got a song you can sing.
What is it?
Your guitar, I'll play for you. Sing.
Watch that cable. The cable's kind of all wrapped around the shit. I thought, you know.
Uh-oh, my wife wants the Billy's Choir, so.
Okay.
I still love my darling, so I will do it for you, but. What's that?
I get to do it live. The lyrics, so I get to
do it live. I won't have to do it live, I think.
I get the lyrics for a second.
Take your time. I got my lyrics, but they came up on the screen there.
Hope everybody's doing
good. Mark, which one? I'm saying you have this down. This is an incredible setup here.
I know. It's.
If you guys could see what's going on here behind it, it's like a TV show. And what's that for Penn? University Penn back there?
Yeah, that's part of the Palestra.
That's actually from the Palestra.
Wow. That's your baby.
That's the floor.
Right on. I spent a month one here one night with Kenn about, I don't know, 10, 11 years ago.
I think it was actually 10. It wasn't 11. It was 9 or 10. It wasn't 11.
It was good.
You were filling in. You know what's funny? You were filling in for me.
Really?
I think we did a couple weeks here.
It's always good that ride home. You don't know where the hell you're at. Sometimes you're downtown. You can grow up down here. You make a wrong turn. You're, oh, man.
Yeah.
I'm going the wrong way.
Yeah, I never sang this. I love this song. I think I could do it.
What song?
Nowhere Man by the Beatles. And this is John Lennon.
Oh, wow.
And John Lennon wrote this.
Which part are you going to do? Which part are you going to do?
I just...
He's going to... What he'll do is he'll follow Mike.
All right, let's do that.
I don't even know, like, the bait, like...
He's a real...
We don't have to rehearse.
Can you do the lower one?
He's a real... He's a real...
Can you do the lower one?
He's a real nowhere man.
Sitting in is nowhere land. Taking on is nowhere land. Oh, nobody.
Does it have a point of view? Knows not where he's going to. Isn't he a bit like you and me? Nowhere man, please listen.
Trust in you, oh please.
love you too. Oh, please don't hurt my pride like her. If I couldn't stand the pain, and I would decide if our new love wasn't vain. So I hope you see that I would love to love you, and that she will cry when she learns we are two. But I couldn't stand the pain, and I would be sad if our new love wasn't vain. So I hope you see that I would love to love you, and that she will cry when she learns we are two. If I fell in love with you,
realize I was that high.
What album is that from?
That was awesome.
I was like, I was waiting to see which part you would go to. I was gonna do that part. You went high. I was like, all right, I'll go low.
I don't know why I did that.
Who is that, McCartney or Lennon?
I think it's.
Lennon. I think it's, that was both, yeah, of them. That was, yeah, the two.
That, that, yeah. I get that Lennon course in there. You have the Lennon change.
Oh yeah, they definitely had the Lennon hard.
And head door. Or did they, yeah, change? You know,
God,
I would.
What is
that? That's a great song, man. Forget about those early Beatles songs. Holy shit.
You say you love me, if I have to go, you'll be thinking of me, somehow I will know. Someday when we're dreaming, wishing you weren't so far away, then we can remember.
Yeah, I'm lost on that one.
I'm just a lonely guy. Love to hear you say that love is love. And though it may be prime, love is here to stay. And that's enough to make you mine, girl. Love you all the time. We'll go on and on, girl, till the end of time.
That's a great stuff. That early stuff. All
I'm lost on that one.
Yeah, yeah. It's
early. I do this one for my wife, who's hopefully still watching, because she requests this song and I have to do it, so. Christmas is the time to say I love you. Share the joys of laughter and good cheer. Christmas is the time to say I love you, and a feeling that'll last all through the year. 3, 4. The carolers are singing, on the touch of magic in the air. From grown up to minor, and no one could be finer. Times are hard, but no one seems to care. Christmas Eve, and all the world is watching. Santa's got his reindeer through the dark. From Rudolph to Jimmy, and Harlem to Bimini, they will find their way into your heart. Christmas is the time to say I love you. Share the joys of laughter and good cheer. Christmas is the time to say I love you, and a feeling that'll last all through the year. Just outside the window, snow is falling. Here beside the fire, we share the glow. A moon top and brandy, and sweet talking candy. Sentiments that everyone should know. Memories of the year that lays behind us. Wishing for the year that's yet to come. And it stands to reason, a good friends and season make you feel that life is just beyond. A Christmas is the time to say I love you. Share the joys of laughter and good cheer. Christmas is the time to say I love you, and a
a feeling that'll last all through the year. When spirits grow brighter and also shine brighter, then you'll know that Christmas time is here.
We're going to do a rave now.
Get you some Molly. Do some Molly.
I see trees of green and roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, beautiful morning, dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, the smiling faces of the people walking by. I see friends shaking hands, how do you do? Everybody's saying, I love you. I hear babies crying, I watch them grow. They know much more than I could ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Most places.
Here it is.
Who wrote that?
That Louis Armstrong. Damn,
I don't know. He sang
it. I think he wrote it.
I think he sang it on his deathbed or something.
No.
No.
It was one of his big hits.
He died right after he sang that. It's a true story.
All I know is,
what a wonderful world.
He died like 2 days later. I got the story. Look it up. Someone Google.
Look it up.
I'm so light.
Oh. It's hard work, got it. What key's it?
He doesn't know.
I don't know, man.
You sing song.
Let me think of something.
I think the biggest
song. There's a lot of people want to hear Remember Me, so.
Oh, we could do that,
I just want to say that.
I think the biggest song so far tonight was Heroin. That was definitely.
Oh, my wife's getting in the hot tub. Nice. Must be nice.
Is this okay?
Oh,
man,
Jen,
hold on a second.
That tuner don't work. Oh, George wants to hear Norwegian Wood. So. Awesome, guys. Oh, Candy Store, that was a request.
Hi, Annie from Chicago. Annie from Chicago listening out there. Hello.
I remember me. We could do it. Yeah. It's a key of G. It's 1-4-5. And then, what's a B? But you would do B minor or B major? What do you want?
Everyone, we need to know. We've been on way past our normal time.
Yeah.
So we're only going to do a couple more. So if you have any requests, get them up now.
Get them up now, baby. And we do take tips on occasion.
Yeah. And while we're waiting, we'll leave.
Got me pissed. Sucker punch.
Well, it's cold and it's raining. And the streets look like glass. And me, I'm just walking alone with my past. I'm standing on 4th Street with everything that I am.
Oh, we don't be fire.
Right across 2nd Tunnel, we put fire. Used to be my home. Remember me. I'm your friend. Yes, I am. Remember me. We live together.
taxi cab. Remember me, I'm the man you said you gotta love her. These sandals I'm wearing, you gave me last year. And this coat that I just bought, we stole New Year's Eve. But over the rainbow, where all those good things lie.
Major.
I'm gonna wish you by and by.
I'll make up for it.
Remember me, I'm your friend. Yes, I am. Remember me, we lived together. Yes, we did. Remember all the fun we had, making love in a taxi cab. Remember me, I'm the man you said you're gonna love forever. Yes, I am. Remember me, remember me. We lived together, yes, we did. Remember all the fun we had, making love in a taxi cab. Remember me, I'm the man you said you're in love forever. Yeah, remember me, remember me. I'm your friend. Remember me.
Thank you, George. We love you, man. Are you drinking scotch? Are you drinking scotch, George? Are you?
Found this in my truck. I got a lot of trash in my truck. I was like, wow, look at this. It's like I had a couple of them, but they usually break. And but this one didn't break. Yeah.
Cool.
We should all thank
Mr. Mike lecompt.
Was my
legend himself.
Pleasure to see you with us tonight.
Thank you guys.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you.
Michael lecompt, motherfuckers.
Thank you for having me.
Awesome having him here.
It's trio, motherfuckers. You gotta do
this again. We're gonna do it live. We'll do it live again.
But we'll all be drinking.
We'll do it again. And next time we're gonna get Galuccio here and.
Yes.
Get Anthony Galuccio, man. We'll get him.
He's coming.
Hopefully in the near future. This was wonderful. This was wonderful as it was. It was
great.
Really, really informal, creative.
No rehearsing.
Fun. No rehearse. Fuck rehearsals.
Yeah. Rehearsal just fucks things.
Unless we work out before the rehearsal.
Oh. Yeah. What's this? Like George, friends of low places.
I forget that five taxi ending.
Joe Mahoney. Hey, man. Joe.
So, Mike, do you want to take us out? We'll do one more song. You want to take us out?
Want to take us out?
Okay.
Some of the possibilities? What do you got?
This one. And you can all sing it, too.
You know what that chord is,
right? Hey, too. found her. Now go and get her. Remember to cut her in your heart. Then you can start to make it better, 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 better. Yeah! La 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 la. Yeah. La 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 la.
Thank you, guys.
What a great night, man.
That was awesome.
Thank you, Michael Lecompt, man. Holy shit.
You have to hear Elvis' version of that. It's great because he does this ad-lib at the end.
Really?
Listen to it tonight. It's great.
It's a live version, like on YouTube?
No, it's not live. It's a studio version.
A studio, okay.
Yeah, but he does. It's great. You got to hear it.
Check that. That's hilarious. That's fucking great.
We got to put that on.
Thank you guys for having me tonight. Thanks.
Okay, thank you, man.
Mike, that was
Michael
awesome.
Michael Lecompt. That's fucking
great. Thanks, everybody. Thanks, okay. Everybody watching.
Thank you, everybody, for watching. Thank you, my cousin, Chris Wester. Thank you, man. George. All right. Love you guys. Rolling, motherfucker.
Say good night, everybody. Good night.
Shower. Take care. We love you, motherfuckers.
Thank you. Yeah.
That was really fun, man.
That was awesome.
That was
so great.
It was incredible, man.
The oil started kicking in.
You know, it was really great that it took us a lot, like months to do it, because we've been talking about you for months. It was
We got to get a little Michael Lecompt out here.